This is the location for the greenhouse. You can see the foundation blocks that I have laid out. These ones in the center are straight up and down, or they're level. The ones on either side are tilted because I'm actually going to build with arches rather than very traditional, I don't know, 2x4 type of construction. So I've been cleaning logs with a draw knife. I have a few of them over here. All right, this is in the workshop. What I set up here is a place to use the draw knife and clean the bark off of the logs. This one was a hickory, and man, the bark is like armor. I'd have to sharpen my draw knife about every 3 feet. So just do that with the little file here. Yeah, probably could make it sharper, but it keeps it sharp enough so you can keep cutting through the outside. So yeah, this one was tenacious. I probably spent an hour or more cleaning this one because it's so tough. But behind me here on the ground is the patterns that I made for my parabolic shape. And I did that by hanging a chain up in the air from 2 points and then putting plywood up behind it and then tracing the line onto the plywood. So this allows us to invert it and to get it a shape that we can work with to build a log arch. So we'll be figuring out how to get logs into this pattern and cutting them with the right angles. And we'll lay those out here and then go out and build it out at the on top of the blocks out there. I have the first 3 sections of the log arch cut and with the right angles and ready to be assembled. We have 1-inch dowels going into 1-inch holes, and I'm about to assemble that. Here is my dowel cutter and the dowel spinner. This is for the 1-inch. Here's an example of a dowel that I've already cut through this. We'll show this working in another clip here with this video. But I want to introduce my 1-inch dowels and how I'm making those. Put a cross onto here to centerline both holes between the joints. Yeah, this is working really good. I'm very pleased with how these are going to connect. A hickory branch. It's already semi-round, so I'm using those. This is my spinner. I have 3 screws into it to help it stay in place and to keep it relatively centered when I spin it. And so we want to show the die cutter and the spinner in action. So here we go. one hickory pig. Here's the completed four sections. This forms half of the parabolic arch. I'm very pleased with the log arch results. When this is in place, reinforced, and supported, it'll be very strong, super strong. The reason that this will be so strong is shown by the line underneath on the pattern that it's sitting on top of. That line represents the force line, and so just like if you're to stack one brick on the other, it doesn't want to lean in or out. It just wants to, you know, gravity pulls it straight down. Gravity is pulling all the force that we put onto this arch straight down along that line. And so I believe this is a superior way to build as far as strength is concerned. And it's not very quick, but it does conserve resources quite well.